This is Matthew with another tip from Advantage Technical Services. Today's lesson, we're going to discuss how to back up all of your files and settings from Production House for doing a reinstall, install on a new computer, or upgrade from one version to a new version. This part covers backing up all of your data and keeping all of your original settings. First of all, we want to make sure that any files we have in our buffered queue are removed. So anything that we don't need, I'm just going to go through and grab most of these. We're just going to delete those out of the queue. And the rest of these are jobs that perhaps we need to keep or jobs we've already ripped that we just want to be able to copy back into the directory and not have to do all the settings for. What we'll do is we'll minimize Production House for the moment and go into our My Computer, and under our install directory in Onyx, in this case we're using Onyx 10, there's a folder in the directory called work. And this work directory will have all of the printers you have installed. In this case, we're dealing with our DesignJet L25500. And in there, we have all of the files that are associated with the jobs in our buffered queue or in our print queue. What we will do is create a new folder that we'll use for a temporary folder to hold all of this information. And in that folder, we'll just make another folder called Buffered Jobs. And that's where we'll take and put all of these files. Now, depending on the size of these files, this could take quite a bit of time. In this case, not very long at all. So now we're done with that part. We move on to the next step. Now you've noticed that we've gotten rid of all of our buffered files because we've copied them out of the work directory. We're ready to go on to our next step, which is creating our print install. Just go up to our file menu and select Manage Printers. If you're running Windows 7, you will get this administrative privileges. If you are not an administrator on this computer, you may have issues with this. So make sure you've got an administrator login or run as administrator when you open up Onyx. This stop processing message is fairly common. Basically what this is reminding you of is if you have any jobs currently printing or any jobs ripping, getting ready to print, this will stop those two processes. If you need to, press no, wait for those jobs to process, and then continue with this step. Now the printer we're concerned about at this point is our DesignJet 25500, and we're just going to highlight it and then hit Create Print Inst. This will give us a selection for all of our media profiles. We can select which ones we do and don't want to output. In our Quicksets, we're actually going to back these up later, so I'm going to uncheck those. And then for our print drivers, it's got both the 42-inch and the 60-inch. You can deselect ones that you don't want for your personal use to customize this even more. Go ahead and click on Next. It'll ask us where we want to save this file. We'll save it into the same directory as we did before. We've already got one. We're just going to overwrite that one for right now. This will take a moment. Once it's finished, we'll be able to continue on in our process. And our print install is completed. All we have to do now is just click on Done. Our final step is to back up our Quicksets. Now, if you use Quicksets regularly, this is essential. But if you don't use them that much, or if you don't use them at all, then you can simply fast forward and continue on with backing up all the rest of your data. We're going to go to Configure Printer. We'll get our server shutdown message. If you're in Windows 7 or Windows Vista, you'll get your UAC message. And then the very first tab that comes up is Quicksets. We're just going to click on Export, and we're going to save it to the same directory that we saved our buffered jobs and our print install. Once that's completed, we click OK. And then as a final step, I like to print out a test image. And what this allows me to do is have a before and after that I can look at and print the same file afterwards. Normally the one I use is if you go to your Onyx install directory, and then go to your samples folder, you've got a PDF for Onyx quality test. Once this Onyx quality test gets buffered in, there's one last step that I like to do. Here in Preflight, if you go to your very last tab, you've got a print setup button. In there, there's a marks tab, and you can click on print label. To enable that, will allow you to print information like the name of the file, where it came from, any profiles that you use to print it with. That way when you reprint it, you use all of the exact same settings and are able to verify that your before and after products are similar or better than what you were expecting. Click on OK and submit this job. And then once it's done processing, click on our printer, click on Print Now to print out that sample, and then we'll move on to our next step of uninstalling and reinstalling a new version of Onyx.